You're watching Tag TV.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
India is well known around the world for its culture and heritage. Its ancient scripture and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I am your host Emma, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. If there is any South Indian festival that can match the glitters of Diwali in North India, Navaratri in Gujarat, Durga Puja in West Bengal and Ganesh Chaturthi in Maharashtra, then it is Madurai's Float Festival. Observed on the full moon night between mid-January and mid-February, the festival is celebrated since 17th century at the famous Meenakshi Amman Temple of the city.
Madurai, a temple town in Madurai, was wrapped up in blanket of colours as the city observed the famous float festival at the famous Meenakshi Amman Temple. Traditionally known as Thepotsav, the festival begins with the spectacular procession of the embellished idols, Goddess Meenakshi and Lord Sundareshwar during the wee hours of the day. The deities are transported from the Meenakshi Temple to Mariamman Thepakulam Lake in Golden Palanquins, accompanied by musicians and devotees. Then they are placed and worshipped in a makeshift mandap on the bank. Afterwards, the idols are prepared for a boat ride on a raft-like structure festooned with flowers and fabrics. Devotees were happy to be a part of this wonderful occasion as it provided them an opportunity to come out of their houses and celebrate after a long COVID period. Rope pulling by the cheering crowd of people is the most interesting part of the occasion. There are two ropes tied to the float. One is pulled by men on the island and the other by those on the bank to draw the float for rounds in the lake. For crowd management and traffic regulation, around 1,000 police personnel were deployed by the city police. Moreover, fire and rescue teams were also stationed along with boats to rescue people in case of untoward incidents. This was for the second consecutive year that the tank housing the float was filled up to the brim, otherwise the ritual used to be conducted in less quantity of water. Dating back to 17th century, the festival was initiated by Tirumalai Nayak, the king of Madurai. After the king commissioned the construction of the lake over an area of 5 kilometers, every year on his birth anniversary, the principal ceremony of taking the idols on a boat ride across the lake started. Even today, this festival has maintained its magnificence and is even thronged by people from outside.
in Tepatiruvula and many people are joining us, and if this COVID situation has been over, it will be happy. So I'm first time on Madurai seeing this Tepatiruvula, and fully it was been decorated and very nice.
In the evening, the island temple is ostentatiously lit with colorful lamps and lights, making the site a mesmerizing one. Decorated with fairy lights and oil lamps, the lake looks nothing short of a paradise, and the reflection of lights and lamps in the lake water makes it look even more appealing.
India is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. The unity of this myriad faiths can be very well witnessed at the dargahs of Sufi saints. So today, we take you to Dargah of Mai Sahiba in New Delhi that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities.
Hidden behind the shops of Archini Market on Sri Aurobindo Marg in the bustling capital city of New Delhi lays an 800-year-old Dargah. This is the Dargah of Mai Sahiba, the mother of 14th century Sufi Saint Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia, which is cherished and worshipped by people from near and far. Devotees of all faiths visit this holy Dargah to offer their obeisance to the Sufi saint.
बहुत आना जाना लगा रहता है, बहुत मिला, बहुत दिया, बहुत मन्नतें पूरी हुई, और आस्था का सवाल है तो क्या हिंदू और क्या वो, जिस दरबार में श्रद्धा से जाओ वहाँ सब कुछ मिल जाता है, और यहाँ सब कुछ मिला, तो अच्छा लगता है यहाँ आना.
Said to be buried at her home, Bibi Zulekha Sahiba, better known as Mai Sahiba, died in the year 1250. The Dargah is seen as a storehouse of blessings where all the cries and prayers of devotees are heard as well as answered. It is mostly visited by devotees, especially women and children, because of the belief that Mai Sahiba cannot bear the sorrow of women and children and bestows her blessings on them.
इस दरबार की खासियत यह है कि जब इंसान यहाँ परेशान हाल आता है, माई साहब की दुआओं से वो खुश होकर जाता है इस दरबार से और झोलियाँ भर के जाता है. इनकी दुआओं में अल्लाह ने वो ताकत दी है कि आदमी सुबह दुआ मांगता है, शाम तक दुआ पूरी होती है इस दरबार से. ये हज़रत निज़ामुद्दीन औलिया महबूब इलाही फरमाते हैं कि मेरे दरबार में जिस शख्स को देर हो रही हो दुआ में और काम में, कि मेरी वालदा के दरबार में जाइए, वहाँ फौरन दुआ कबूल होती है.
The Dargah of Mai Sahiba is a perfect example of communal harmony that is witnessed throughout the length and breadth of our country. The solidarity among the different religious communities has remained a hallmark of India's unity since time immemorial.
Now we round up with some of the major stories that made news recently.
Bollywood film producers recently interacted with travel operators in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, eyeing the Himalayan Valley as the next big destination for shooting with the backdrop of breathtaking snow-capped hills, shikara boats dominated lakes, adventure spots and stunning meadows. With fresh snowfall and a slow and gradual return of normalcy in the valley, the influx of tourists has also started to grow. Bollywood sees this as an opportunity to revive the trend of filming in Kashmir.
No, I think it will not only be revived to past glory, it can even be surpassed. And I think Kashmir should look not just as Bollywood, but even Hollywood, you know, to come and shoot here, because I don't think you can get such a great location and such a depth of seasons and scenery anywhere else. So I think it's just the beginning, and we will definitely exceed what we had in the past.
Kashmir has always justified its identity as photographer's paradise, and in the golden era of Bollywood, many filmmakers visited it to capture the Himalayan Valley.
The Archaeological Survey of India or ASI has unearthed a stone structure suspected to be the floor of a 10th century temple during excavation near the 11th century Lingraj temple in Bhubaneswar. The structure was found in the wake of the demolition work being undertaken by Odisha Bridge and Construction Corporation Limited and Bhubaneswar Development Authority as part of the Ekamwa Kshetra project for purification of Lingaraj Temple and its periphery. The ASI also discovered two other structures believed to be the remains of small shrines and a portion of the Sari Temple. These findings have led ASI experts to believe that the Sari temple complex was built on the Panchayatana model, where the main temple is surrounded by four subsidiary shrines. Vinayak Kesham of Manipur has been conferred with the prestigious Pradhan Mantri Rashtriya Bal Puraskar 2021 for the extraordinary work in the field of art. Along with the rest of the awardees, Vinayak also joined the interaction with Prime Minister Narendra Modi via video conferencing.
It is an honor to get an opportunity to have interaction with the Honorable Prime Minister, and he also gave us encouragement, so it was very motivating. So I feel really excited and very grateful.
A student of class 11, Vinayak has bagged several awards, including 3 international level, 10 national level awards and 300 state awards. She loves to paint and sing and aspires to become an art professor.
India is abhorrent to different religions and beliefs that are cherished and practiced by its citizens. Gracefully embracing this uniqueness, people across communities keep on putting forward examples that testify the communal bond and amiability among them and are recognized and appreciated by many. So today, we will meet one such person from Coimbatore city of Tamil Nadu who has been awarded for his effort to ensure religious harmony in his region.
Republic Day is special to all the Indians, but this year's Republic Day celebrations brought new enthusiasm in the life of K.A. Abdul Jabbar. On this day, Jabbar was recognized for all the work he has been doing for years to ensure communal harmony. For the same, he has been conferred with the prestigious Kottai Amir Communal Harmony Award by Tamil Nadu's Chief Minister E. Palaniswamy.
நான் கோவை மாவட்ட குடியமைத்துறை சேர்ந்தவன். நான் கடந்த 25 வருடங்களாக சோசியல் வேலையும் கல்வி உதவி, மருத்துவ உதவி, திருமண உதவி எல்லா அனைத்து மதங்களுக்கும் ஜாதி மத பாகுபாடின்றி செய்து வருகிறேன். அந்த இதை பாராட்டி தமிழ்நாடு அரசு எனக்கு மத நல்லிணக்க விருதினை வழங்கியிருக்கிறது. அதற்கு அரசுக்கு நன்றி தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். நான் இந்த விருதுகளை எல்லாம் கேட்காமல் எதிர்பார்க்காம தான் எல்லா வேலையும் செஞ்சிட்ருக்கிறோம். திருமண உதவிகளையும் செஞ்சிட்ருக்கிறோம். எல்லாத்தையுமே குனியமுத்தூர் பகுதி இல்லாமல் கோவை மாவட்டத்தில் உள்ள பரவலான எல்லா பகுதிகளுக்கும் செஞ்சிட்ருக்கிறோம். இதற்கு நான் இருக்கும் ஜமாத்துலேயும் எல்லோரும் உதவி செஞ்சிட்ருக்கிறாங்க. நாங்கள்லாம் ஒரு டீம் ஒர்க்காக செஞ்சிட்ருக்கிறோம்.
A resident of Kuniyamuthur in Coimbatore, Jabbar has been selling communal concord amongst completely different communities for years. He renders social service by conducting eye camps, blood donation camps, medical camps and distributes education aid. His Jamaat, namely Tajul Islam Sunnat Jamaat, has been organizing Samudhava Diwali with the people from all religions for the last 4 years.
The Tamil Nadu government, Madan Alana Kaviran, and Abdul Jabbar, or Palaganar, are the catering number Perimir Kaya number, and Erika number, Nukudosa Kalama, and a cover Latirio. On the timeline, they are Rembo in the public support work for no. பண்ணிகிட்டே இருந்தார். ஸ்டார்டிங்லேருந்து நல்லா ஒர்க் பண்ணுவார். எல்லா மாதத்திற்கும் ஒரு நல்ல ஒரு பொதுவான ஒரு மனுஷன் நல்லா பண்ணிகிட்டு இருப்பார். எங்களை வந்து என்கேஜ் பண்ணுவார், நீங்கள் பண்ணோம் வாங்க அது பண்ணலாம் இது பண்ணலான்னு நிறைய இதை எங்களையும் கூப்பிட்டு இப்போ பண்ணிச்சுட்டு இருக்காரு. அவர் பண்ணிகிட்டே இருப்பார், என்கேஜ் பண்ணிகிட்டே இருப்பார். அவருக்கு ஒரு லேட்டாக கிடைச்சது, இப்போ கிடைச்சது ரொம்ப சந்தோஷமாக இருக்குது. ஏன் கேட்டிங்கன்னா தமிழ்நாடு கவர்மெண்ட்டு அவர் இப்போ அவர் புரியுதுக்கு இவ்வளோ டைம் ஆயிடுச்சு. இந்த காலத்துக்கு அப்புறம் அவர் கிடைச்சதுன்னு கேட்டு அவர் விருது கொண்டு கொடுத்து நாங்கள் ரொம்ப பெருமைப்படும். ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாம் நாங்கள்லாம் எப்போவுமே அவர் எதுக்கு போகும்போது ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாம் கூப்பிட்டு வருவாங்க, நம்ம அது பண்ணலாம் இதை பண்ணலாம் என்கரேஜ் பண்ணிகிட்டே இருப்பார். அவர் பார்க்கும்போது எங்களுக்கு ஒரு பாசிட்டிவ் எனர்ஜி வரும்.
It is due to citizens like Jabbar who have been working tirelessly towards noble causes that India stands undivided and stronger.
With tourism continuously blooming in the country, citizens and organizations are coming up with new and innovative ideas to attract more tourists. One such innovative cafe has been opened in India's favorite snow destination Gulmarg, which is attracting eyeballs of tourists and citizens around the nation.
Tourism in Jammu and Kashmir's Gulmarg town has just touched a higher notch with its first igloo cafe. Opened up at Kalohi Ski Resort, the newly opened cafe offers hot food and drinks to tourists who come to the snow-clad town on a vacation or for a snow sports.
ये जो कॉन्सेप्ट है ये इंडिया के लिए नया है, लेकिन यूरोपियन कंट्रीज़ में ये बहुत जगहों पे बना है, लाइक फिनलैंड है, नॉर्वे, स्विट्ज़रलैंड में है. ये कॉन्सेप्ट बेसिकली हमारा एमडी साबेज, वो जो खुद एक ट्रैवलर है, उनके ही जहन में आया कि हम कुछ नया बनाएंगे गुलमर्ग में जो कि एक अट्रैक्शन रहे टूरिस्ट के लिए. लकली तो ये बहुत ही सक्सेसफुल हुआ और बहुत ही अट्रैक्शन का एक साइट बन गई यहाँ पर गुलमर्ग में. हमारी एडवांस बुकिंग इसके लिए आ रही है. इस लंच या डिनर यहाँ पर होता है और साइट सीइंग के लिए भी आते हैं, फोटोग्राफ्स लेते हैं लोग. ये सेल्फी पॉइंट एक बन गया है गुलमर्ग में.
Deriving inspiration from the Arctic shelters, the cafe is entirely made of snow with a tint of local touch in it, like the arched door and the patterns on the walls. The cafe promises good time to its guests and has benches and tables made up of snow placed inside instead of traditional furniture. With a height of 15 feet and circumference of 26 feet, the cafe has a seating capacity of 16 people on 4 tables. Tourists are enthralled on visiting this new cafe for a lifetime experience.
Gulmarg hamara hamesha se favorite raha hai. Is baar ye igloo cafe ne humko surprise kar diya. And it's very beautiful. I think sare tourist ko yahan aana chahiye. Ye bilkul safe jagah hai and it's a must visit.
With the introduction of this cafe, the pictures and videos of this cafe is making round on social media and netizens are going crazy over its images.
Last but not the least, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings across Asia in our new edition, Asia in Focus.
Online fashion retailer Zozo Inc. has recently launched their skin tone measuring glasses for ordering cosmetics online in the latest fashion tech from the company as it expands beyond apparel. Zozo Glass, a pair of glasses covered with color swatches and markers, detects skin tone when scanned with a smartphone for tailored cosmetics recommendation on its Zozo Town site. Zozo Glass usage was limited to foundation initially before expansion to other product line.
But for Zozo Glass, color is everything. So it's really difficult to buy cosmetics if you don't know what color to buy. And foundation, from our research, is one of the most difficult to buy. And so for these first-time buyers online, they're exploring different brands. This tool will give them a starting point. So after you scan your face, you know what color your face is.
Yeah.
And then on the product pages, you'll see, you know, there'll be a little highlight. It'll say you. So you'll see a little highlighted circle next to the color of the product. And from there, you can choose if you want to go lighter, darker.
Augmented reality functionality will be also added to the online retailer's app soon to allow consumers to see how the makeup will look. Saudi Arabia opens its first drive-in movie theater in Riyadh to allow viewers to enjoy watching a movie while taking the necessary precautionary measures against the spread of COVID-19. The movie theater can accommodate up to 150 cars while applying social distancing measures. Wearing masks and checking temperatures are mandatory.
بصراحة تجربة سينما السيارات تجربة رائعة. ما توقعت انه بتكون بالشيء اللي انا قاعده اشوفه في السعوديه اول مره يصير سينما السيارات بصراحه برافو.
Drive-in cinemas popped up in other parts of the Middle East since the outbreak of coronavirus pandemic, with similar venues opening in Dubai and Beirut early last year. With a treehouse exterior and walls designed to resemble branches, this Palestinian cafe hopes to surround its customers with a feel in the West Bank city of Nablus. Famous for its use of wooden benches and soft, earthy tones, the cafe is designed for visitors to unwind with calm, nature-like surroundings and has become known for its tasty coffee and traditional Middle Eastern cuisine.
هذا المكان كثير كثير حلو يعني اول ما افوت عليه بذكرني بايام زمان ايام يعني مثل ما بيحكوا نابلس دمشق الصغرى فلما فتحوا هذا المكان فحسيت انه عن جد هي دمشق الصغرى وهلا فعليا يعني نابلس البلد القديمه دائما بيجوا عليها كثير ناس فلما يشوفوا محلات مثل هيك فراح يجذبهم اكثر وصير يعني زي كانه بشجعوا السياحه عندنا اكثر في فلسطين.
The Treehouse Cafe was built in 2020 as the world's economy took a dive due to COVID-19 outbreak. The pandemic and prolonged lockdowns in the West Bank have led to severe economic fallout, and owner Ahmed Akub said he is using the cafe as a part of an advertising campaign to attract tourists to the city. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. Now signing off with the glimpses of the 13th edition of Aero India International Air Show, organized at Air Force Station Yelahankar in Bangalore. I'm your host, Emma, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.